Welcome to the Sales Influence Podcast, where we talk about finding the why and how people buy. I'm your host, Victor Antonio. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for lending me your ears. Today, I want to talk about videos and emails. This is kind of a follow-up to my last podcast where I talked about how to use videos throughout your sales process. But now I want to give you real motivation to want to use videos with your sales process or as part of your sales process. Did you know, fact number one, that open rates will increase anywhere from 7 to 13% when you include a video? Ooh, listen to that. Open rates will increase by 7 to 13%, according to a study done by Experian, 7 to 13%. Now, that may not sound big, but that's a huge bump. Even if you just get a 7% open rate increase, you know, all the way to 13, I mean, these are big numbers when you think about it. So that's motivation number one to actually get them to start using them. Motivation number two, your click-through ratio can also go up as high as 21%, according to MediaPost, by including a video. A click-through rate means is that they clicked to open your email, and then there was a link in your email, and they clicked on that one, so they click through. So think about this. Just using video will increase your open rate, and it'll also increase your click rate. Now, let me give you some cool tips, because it's all about finding the why. And not so much how people buy, but why they open their emails. Here are three key tips, and one is going to blow your mind. Number one, personalized video plus a subject line. Now, in other words, when you're sending an email, personalize the video. Don't leave it generic. Don't make it generic like anybody. Say the person's name. Tell them specifically why you're reaching out. Tell her why you're contacting them. Be very specific in what you're talking about. And also, in the subject line, include 6 to 10 words. That seems to be the sweet spot for the number of words. And one more tip, include their first name in the subject line. Let me give you a quick summary of this. First of all, personalize the video. Be very specific. Jill, Bill, right? Say their name. Here's why I'm sending you this video. In the subject line, put their first name, Jill, Bill, and then comma, and then your subject line topic, whatever it is. 6 to 10 words, again, is the sweet spot. So that's tip number one on sending a video email. Tip number two, this one's kind of an easy one, but not. Try to keep it to 60 to 90 seconds. Remember, attention spans are getting shorter and shorter and shorter. You know what I'm talking about. So we want to make sure that those videos are tight. Here's what I would do. This is something I do, I practice, and I'm going to suggest it to you. Do the video the first time. And let's say you do the video the first time, and you're up to, let's say, 3-4 minutes. Let's say 4 minutes, right? And you're like, oh, that's just too long. Then do it again. And you'll find yourself tightening it up. Now, listen carefully. When I say tighten it up, I don't mean speak faster. That's not what I mean. Tightening up means you realize that certain words don't need to be said. Maybe a pieces of information don't need to be stated. So you tighten it up and you may get it down to 3 minutes. And then you do it the third time. And usually the third time, you really get it to as tight as you can. And sometimes you'll hit the 90 seconds and sometimes you simply won't. It's okay. But if you feel that the content you provide is like 100% unadulterated, no fat, all pure unadulterated content, then you're good. See, 60 to 90 seconds is kind of a rule of thumb. But in reality, it really depends on the type of video you're sending. So for example, if you're sending an instructional video, you want to actually walk them through the process. You may need more time. So don't be fixated on 60 to 90 seconds. That would be ideal if you can do it, but certain videos require you to go a little longer. But take my suggestion. Do the video the first time, do it the second time, and by the third time, you'll have it as tight as you can, and that is the one that you send. Last point, this is going to shock you. Did you know that 81% of the people view their emails through their phones? 81% view their emails through their phones, and only 19% view them through a laptop or a desktop. Now, think about this for a second. If people are viewing 81% of all emails via phone, then the question is, how should you film your video? Should it be landscape, sideways, or should it be vertical, top down? Pretend that you're holding your phone. Is it vertical or do you turn it sideways and go landscape? Well, the answer is now apparently obvious, because if the majority of people are watching videos via their phone, then you want to go vertical to make it easy. Now, people can tilt their phones and maybe it'll expand, maybe it won't. But the reality is, let's make it easy. So if you can film your video in vertical mode, that is your best option. So again, let's incorporate videos in our emails because they increase the open rates, they increase the click-through rates. And when we're doing that, when we're sending videos, let's personalize them, let's use their first name, and then keep the subject line 6 to 10 words. Tip number two, keep them short, 60 to 90 seconds. And if they have to be longer, do it 3 times till you finally get that video tight, tight, tight. And number three is, again, the majority of people are viewing their videos, their emails rather, through their phones, which means maybe you want to go vertical on your video. And that is it for the Sales Influence Podcast. Leave me some feedback on iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, Spotify, Pandora, wherever you can find me. I'd love to hear from you. And also, when you get a chance, check out the Sales Velocity Academy. If you want to learn how to sell more faster, check out salesvelocityacademy.com. And that's it for this Sales Influence Podcast. This is Victor Antonio, always reminding you, selling ain't hard when you can video correctly and you know how. Take care.
Hi, I'm Victor Antonio. I'm an author, sales trainer, and keynote speaker. I'm often asked, what makes a great speaker? Is it someone who delivers real content that the audience can use? Is it someone who engages the audience so they're part of the learning experience? Or is it someone who can motivate an audience to push them beyond their comfort zone and discover new abilities? The answer is yes. But the most important thing to remember is that I'm not there to look good. I'm there to make my client look good. Simply put, it's never about me, and it's always about them.